Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm Ryan. We're from Yellow Card. Welcome to Sessions at AOL.
The term yellow card in the dictionary or whatever is from the game of soccer. It's when you slide tackle someone wrong or you cuss at a player, you get a yellow card. When we were in high school, we incorporated a yellow card into party fouls.
My parents would go to St. Martin for 10 days every year. And my house sort of became famous. Pete, our bass player, who wasn't the bass player at the time, he wasn't in the band then either. He called me and he was just like, I'm in the neighborhood, I need somewhere to crash. Is there anything at your house to drink? He and his friend came over and apparently ate a bunch of chips and salsa and then took a shot out of every single bottle of liquor in my dad's liquor cabinet.
That's what it was.
And they went in my parents' bedroom. And Pete was sound asleep, and I walked around the other side of the bed, and his friend had salsa'd my parents' white down comforter down their mahogany bed and into their white carpet. I was so, so pissed I made him cry. But that's a yellow card for sure.
There's a place off Ocean Avenue where I used to sit and talk with you. We were both 16 and it felt so right.
The title Ocean Avenue comes from when we lived. I had this place on the beach kind of next to Ocean Avenue, and that's where, I don't know, we had such great times writing. It was when we were young and carefree. For Yellow Card, incorporating the violin is something very natural for all of us.
We are quite aware of what punk rock is and how it influences our music, but I don't think we're a punk rock band. I think we're a very melody-rich rock band, and I think having a violin only helps us expand on our melodies and thicken our songs.
Made my mistakes, let you down, and I can't hold on for
Another band that just signed to Capitol called Stereogram. They're our friends from New Zealand, and if you've ever been over there, you know that New Zealanders and Australians are very independent people. From each other.
Completely different countries. Like, don't get them mixed up.
Yeah, do not call a Kiwi an Australian and vice versa. Well, our friends are from New Zealand, and they were on the Something Corporate tour with us earlier this year, and their last day of the tour, we flew a huge Australian flag behind them, and two of the tour managers on the tour rented kangaroo suits and jumped out, came out on the stage, and were jumping around on the stage.
And they switched out their intro music to I Come From the Land Down Under.
Yeah. You can tell the difference in the fam that's been with us since we started and one that's brand new, you know, because a lot of the newer ones just only care about that picture or that autograph, you know, and there'll be an old fan standing right next to him going like, leave them alone, you know, they're whatever. It's cool though, because the old school fans will definitely have our back.
And I've thrown my words all around, but I can't.
You can have anyone in the world, who would it be? I would genuinely enjoy taking Alison Lohman out to dinner. She's really talented, and I think she's extremely attractive.
I think Catherine Zeta-Jones is hot.
She's married to an 80-year-old.
Sorry, dude.
Here I go.
Now we're gonna put you on the spot. Brittany or Christina?
Brittany.
Brittany.
She parties way harder. I'm way into her.
Fantasy Island or Temptation Island?
Ooh, I like
Temptation Island.
Oh yeah, Temptation.
Nude or pajamas?
Nude.
Nude.
Driver or passenger?
Driver.
Morning or night?
Night.
Night.
New York City or Los Angeles?
New York City.
Pinball or PlayStation 2?
PlayStation 2.
Of course.
Low fat or low carb?
Neither.
Can I say neither?
Sure.
Neither.
Cat or dog?
Dog.
Dog, yeah.
Paper or plastic?
Paper. Man.
Beach or poolside?
Beach.
Windows down or air conditioning?
Windows down.
Hamburger or hot dog?
Hamburger.
Jaws or Finding Nemo?
Finding Nemo, man.
Good movie.
Speedo or trunks?
Speedo.
No. He would wear Speedo. I'll take the trunks.
Bikini or one piece?
Come on.
Definitely
a
one
that?
Piece.
Ice cream cone or snow cone?
Ice cream cone.
Ice cream cone. Although snow cone brings back some memories, man.
Campground or hotel? Ooh.
For what?
Which one would you rather? I don't know, man. I like the camping.
I'm a hippie, man. Campground.
Yeah, campground.
Ding, ding.
I back that.
We win.
Roller coaster or merry-go-round?
Roller coaster.
Roller coaster.
Slip and slide or fire hydrant?
Mm-hmm. Slip and slide. At Skate and Surf in New Jersey, good story. They had a slip and slide in the hall at the hotel, and they were using beer to make it wet, and the chicks were sliding down it. It's awesome. But anyways.
Breaking up, it's breaking up. I feel like giving up. Oh my God, it's you, you know. tired. Won't you sing me to sleep and fly through my dreams so I can hitch a ride with you tonight and get away from this place, have a new name and face. I just ain't the same without you in my life. Late night drives, all alone in my car, I can't help but start singing lines from all our favorite songs. And melodies in the air, singing life just ain't fair. Sometimes I still just can't believe you're gone. And I'm sure the view from heaven beats the hell out of my ear. And if we all believe in heaven, maybe we'll make it. Just one more chance to say, I wish that I had gone up with you too. And I'm sure the view from heaven beats the hell out of my ear. And if we all believe in heaven, maybe we'll make it through one more year.
Dream and it gets me by. I can make believe that you're here.